Hey guys, what's up? I'm Christian Taylor, and today I'm going to be talking about the best note-taking solution for your Apple devices. So productivity is a huge thing we all do on our Apple products. Whether it's taking a quick note in a work meeting, or typing on your iPad, taking notes as a student, or just sitting with a client typing notes on your Mac for freelance work, we all have to take notes, and it is part of any productivity process. Now I'm sure you're immediately saying, Christian, what's wrong with the notes app that comes with my iPhone, or my iPad, or my Mac? All my notes already sync between devices, and that's free, and I don't see anything wrong with it. Well, there's not anything wrong with it. I'm just gonna tell you what you're missing and why you could be having a much better experience. You see, I came across this app called Bear and I absolutely fell in love with it. It is the best note-taking app I have ever tried, and today I'm gonna tell you why. So what sets Bear apart from its competitors is the advanced and unique method for doing formatting. So if you wanna make something bold, you put an asterisk before your sentence, you type it out and you put an asterisk after, it automatically makes it bold. If you want to make something italic, you do a slash, your words, and then a closing slash. Or if you want to do a bullet point, you do an asterisk and you just hit the space bar and it converts into a bullet point. Every single formatting option, whether that's italic, strike through, underline, highlight, it all has an option where you type some kind of symbol before and after it and it gives it that format. So why is this useful? Well, it speeds you up. It's much more intuitive than having to select bold or italics or whatever from the list of options, which you can still do, by the way. But I just think it is much better to be able to speed type along and do a quick slash, blah, 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 and a slash, and it's italicized. Now this can be kind of annoying for some people because you can't turn off these semi-transparent symbols. This ticked me off at first. So what I mean is when you do something bold and you use the asterisks or italics in the slash, those slashes are still in your notes. They're stuck. At first I was like, this is incredibly tacky and just lame, but then I kind of got used to it, and I kind of like the slashes for italics or the asterisks for bold. It just adds a little more emphasis. So it's definitely going to be something you either love or you hate. For me, it was an acquired taste, and I now really enjoy having those extra symbols there to emphasize the proper formatting. Now, there are two other massive benefits to Bear. The first one is themes. So if you like a dark mode or just want to change up the look and feel of your note-taking app, you're in luck because Bear supports this across all of your devices. I am a huge advocate for dark mode, especially when I'm gonna be staring at a notes app for 1 hour plus. I don't wanna be having the light notes app that Apple gives you glaring in my eyes or anything. It is much softer and easier on the eyes for me to just look at the dark note-taking app, and I personally like dark mode much better on apps when available. So I was super pleased to see that Bear includes all sorts of themes that you can change easily. In addition, Bear has an Apple Watch app. So while it may seem gimmicky at first, there are a lot of times you're going throughout your day and you want to just make a quick note of something fast on your Apple Watch. And Apple's Notes app does not offer Apple Watch capabilities. So with Bear, everything syncs right to your Apple Watch so you can see your existing notes on your watch at a quick glance, or you can even add a new note using your voice if you just need to jot something down quick, and I really like that. But all of these premium features come at a cost. Now, Bear is a free app, but the thing is, if you want it to sync between your devices, which I think is a must for anybody, and if you want to access the themes, such as the dark ones or the other colors, you have to pay for their premium option. Now, their premium option is available for $1.49 per month or $14.99 per year. I personally subscribe to the yearly option, and I think this is a perfectly reasonable price to pay for anyone who constantly is taking notes on their devices. Let me make clear though that this is exclusively for the Apple ecosystem. So Bear has an iPhone app, an iPad app, a Mac app, and an Apple Watch app. There is no Android app and there is no web version. So if you have a Windows computer or an Android phone, you're out of luck. So this is really meant for someone who is deep into the Apple ecosystem, who uses everything Apple, and is able to fully leverage and take advantage of the platform. Now, the only two features Bear is missing is collaboration and tables. So in the Apple Notes app, they actually let you collaborate with other users so they can see your notes in real time, and Bear is missing this. Now, this doesn't bother me too much because I think if something is collaborative, you could really make it a Google Docs file. Usually that's more of a formal thing like a document, and I don't really see why you would need to collaborate on a note. I think of notes as a personal use type of thing. So whether I'm typing notes on a sermon or just taking notes for a class as a student or for a client, I'm not really seeing the value to collaborative note taking. One definite plus though to the Apple Notes app is tables. There is no option for creating tables yet in Bear, and in Apple Notes it is there. So if you're trying to make some kind of pricing table or just options for a client you're trying to work up, that is not going to be possible in Bear, which is definitely a little bit annoying. Overall though, for its unique formatting, dark mode, and Apple Watch support, I really enjoy using Bear, and it's something that I'm going to be a user with long term. So what do you guys think? Is the note-taking app you use important, or do you not care? Do you just want an app to jot down a couple things and you're not really bothered by which app you use? I'd love to know in the comments down below, and if you like this video, do be sure to hit that subscribe button and click the bell so you don't miss when I release new videos. With that said, I will catch you guys next time.